wheel-to-wheels teenage racing queen Stevie Rogers goes for another Restrictor Plate main event victory on the 4th of July's Firecracker Derby. The Apple Valley 15-year-old has won 5 of 6 Restrictor Plate mains this season and holds a 10-point lead in season championship points. She has been racing for 10 years. How did Stevie Rogers get started racing?
Well, I started racing when I was 4 and a half. I started racing at quarter midgets at the Orange Show, and I had a lot of fun. I won a couple championships, and it was just a lot of fun.
Any significance to the number 3A?
Well, my dad has always been like 3, and then it's like just run through the family, and I got to get it.
Does she feel she has a target on her back that the boys might be trying to gang up on her as she dominates an event that had been won exclusively by boys in seasons past?
I don't know. You know, sometimes I do, sometimes I don't, but I'm just glad that I have a good car and I've learned throughout the years to like go with it, and like I've just learned, and I'm thankful that I have the setup that I have, and it's just I'm so thankful to like have the car that I have.
One of those boys in hot pursuit is 11-year-old Ricky Simpson, who is second in season championship points. What is Ricky Simpson working on most in efforts to overtake the front runner?
I would like to improve my line. We've added a couple parts onto my car, hoping that it would make it faster. I just can't seem to beat them. I'm having a hard time. I'm hoping that I'll be able to beat them soon.
How does the Restrictor Plate, Rookie, compare it to racing intermediates?
Well, of course it's faster. I would say the lines that you try driving to pass people are harder because in these cars you slide up a lot. Of course, it's way harder to do stuff. The nice thing about it is that there's less people in it.
Cash Culp has an excellent night at this June 22nd event, the 6th in the championship series. He continues to dominate in KT100 Juniors and will remain in second in season points among all KT100 dirt kart racers. The 10-year-old out of Nueva races in 3 wheel-to-wheel classes. Cash's mom, Heidi Jo Erickson Culp, Lavender 77, is dirt kart senior season points leader, 1 point up on Blaine Kuhn, in yellow 23. Here is the first intermediates heat race of this June 22nd event. 7, Blake Edsel, Z8, Zate Legend, Dark 2, Sean Rogers, 54 is Junior Podsade, Cash Culp in his green money machine, Blue 8, Ryan Shank the second, 51, Mia Farrell. Sean Rogers overtakes Zate Legend and races to the first checkered of the day. 12-year-old Sean Rogers, nicknamed Gorilla, the younger brother of Stevie Rogers, was last year's Rookie of the Year in intermediates. He will finish second in this night's intermediates main. Second heat race of the day, 99 Dylan Agri, bright yellow 18 is Casper Wright, 58 Jake Adams, silver blue 28 Stevie Simpson, 1 the bandit Braden Miller-Bushy, 23 Jaden Manchester. Tight 5 through the first 3 laps before the bandit pulls away and wins the heat. An excellent tune-up for him climbing the podium by night's end. He will finish 3rd in the intermediates main. This is the intermediates main. Cash Culp, front row inside lane. 7-year-old rookie Dylan Agri, 99. 28, Stevie Simpson, he just turned 10. Orange and black Z8, Zate Legend. Jaden Manchester and Stevie Simpson get tangled up coming out of turn 3. Cash Culp cashes in at the start and will cash out, leading from start to finish. He leads in season points in intermediates. The youngest wheel-to-wheel racers are junior intermediates. Jackson Sowers takes the checkered in this night's junior intermediates main. Boo Lee outlasts Norma Weatherby in the KT100 main. Central California veteran is in 3rd in KT100 season points, 5 behind spunky frontrunner Norma Weatherby, and 3 in back of upstart Cash Culp. Chris Southern marks his return to wheel-to-wheel by taking the checkered in the dirt carts seniors main. John Aden will start from the middle of the pack in the Pro 500 main and overtake John Alonso for the lead midway through this June 22nd main event. John Alonso will hit rough sledding and not finish. Bobby Taylor, 766. Jacob Rogers, 3. and Justin Adams, 59, stage a raging battle to make the podium, Jacob Rogers edging out Justin Adams at the finish line to finish second. Jacob Rogers, 29-year-old, also has patriarch Steve Rogers as his crew chief. Jacob Rogers climbs into fourth in season points with 27. John Aden's checkered gives him 47 season points, 15 up on Bobby Taylor, 19 up on John Alonso. Wheel to Wheels Firecracker Derby has racing begin at 5 on the 4th of July. We take you back to previous Firecracker Derbies on this community table restaurant Throwback Thursday. Video Sports Flashback. Wheel-to-wheel race fans gasp and hold their breath as Trackmaster John Aden goes airborne in the Pro 500 main at the Firecracker Derby. 11 racers are lined up for the main event. Pro 500 season points leader John Alonso, 99, in the pole position. The Firecracker Derby Pro 500 main gets off to a startling start when veteran Brian Streuter goes airborne one lap in. Like John Aden, Brian Streuter is stirred but not badly shaken, escaping uninjured. As this restart shows, John Aden readily and immediately sets his white number 7 apart from the rest of the field. It will be Eric Englert second, Kim Sullivan third. For John Aden, a second consecutive victory in the Speedway Sprint's Pro 500 main, barreling him into the lead in season points at the midway mark of the season. These video sports action highlights and soundbites presented by the Community Table Restaurant located in the Holiday Inn in Victorville. Every Thursday, it's all-you-can-eat popcorn shrimp for just $9.95 at the Community Table Restaurant.